you find everything in the Vedas. All four Vedas can give you all the knowledge of the world, whatever you want. Name it, it is there. So, Natya Veda is supposed to be, it is known as Panchama Veda, that is fifth Veda, compilation from four Vedas, and it is said as Natya Veda, which is used to be the visual communicative system, visual educational system. Unfortunately, after independence, so-called independence, how many years since we got independence from Britishers? How many? 70 years. No?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt? We just celebrated August 15th, the 71st anniversary of our freedom from only Britishers. They were invaders. They were invaders to our country. We have never invaded anybody, because we have everything in our country. We are the most richest country in the world. Have you realized it? Children? This is food for thought, the food for thoughts. We are the richest country in the world. But unfortunately, we are very badly administered nation. That too, after our independence, with all the political parties and all sorts fighting each other, not correct ideology, following ideology, we have really not done well. That's why they call it poor country. We are not poor. We understand. We are rich in our wealth as well as rich in our knowledge. That's why invaders come to plunder us, our knowledge. To plunder our knowledge, and then also many of our great monuments have been stolen away from you, taken away from to other countries. Draining our wealth. We have big brains. In fact, we should be proud. We are all very, very intelligent people. And many of our scientists are helping the world to progress. They are working for others, for the other countries. And you all grow, please don't give away, make your intelligence to make our country prosperous. Will you do that?
Yes.
You don't need to go anywhere else to study. Your professors are great. They can give you whatever you want, the teachers. There are so many great teachers here. One of those teachers, probably, I don't know, you have heard, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. Have you heard?
Yes.
Madan Mohan Malaviya?
Yes.
Yeah, very good, I am glad. Anyway, I'm just giving you a thought, a food for thought. Our country is Bharatam. All born and brought up in this country is known as Bharatiya, not Indians. Who are the Indians? No. American natives are originally called Native Indians of America. Indians. They were called Indians. That history, that's a different part of history. But our country's name is Bharat, always, which has a great deep meaning. Bharam is ignorance. When you are heavy in the head, that means you are ignorant. When you are light, you are enlightened souls. That is knowledge. When you get knowledge, you are enlightened. Well, light, it becomes light. But Bharam is burdened with ignorance. Bharam, tarayati, taray means to eradicate, to expel, to remove the ignorance. Bharam tarayati, the land that removes the ignorance of the whole world is known as Bharata. Will you remember this? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Say yes and be.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Three bags full. This is a full for you. Bhargam is a very, very beautiful name which has been given to us, to this land, by the rishis. And we should decide time that we change the foreign stuck name India and come back to our original name. Let us all be very proud of being a Bharatiya. Anybody, there is no religion, caste, creed or anything. Please, you should have Sahana Bhavatu, Sahana Bhunattu, Sahaviryam Karavavahai, Tejasvina Vadhitamastu, Ma Vidyushavahai. Shanti prevails. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. This is what our philosophy is. Our Bharata Desham's philosophy is to be together, no enemies towards each other. Let us work together for the prosperity of the country and prosperity of every individual. That is the essence of Natya Shastra also. So what we just performed is, as you all know, an oblation, a prayer. To whom did we pray? Ganesha. God Ganesha. Yes, not Lord Ganesha, God Ganesha. We worship gods in different forms. That's a different philosophy that I am not going to deal with, but you can read great souls, then you will understand why we worship and all that. To remove the obstacles, we always worship Ganesha, which is a very beautiful concept as it is. Ganesha, the intelligent being, the elephant being, the intelligent animals, so among all the living things, elephant is supposed to be the highest and very intelligent person. So that's why we bow to him. Now, Bharatanatyam. We have very many classical styles. Every style is based on Bharatanatyam, Natya Shastra. That is given to us by a great rishi called Bharata. His name was also Bharata because he was a very knowledgeable person. That's why he is called Bharata. So, Bharatanatyam, all Natyam that prevailed in our Bharata Desham based on Natya Shastra, and we all follow three aspects, that is Nritya, which is pure rhythmical delineation. Nritya is the textual and mental application, and Natya becomes a storytelling. Through stories, we can educate the young minds. That's how ancient rishis did a syllabus for us. Through stories, we'll also show how it is done. So, Nritya is based on certain patterns called mandala sthanas, like sthanakam, ayatam, alingam, prekhanam, preetam, pratyalingam, swastikam, moditam.
Ujjanvidam,
Samasutika,
Vavishyam, Vandiyam.
They are the basic 10 postures. In your geometry you have basic designs, isn't it? Just like that, that mathematics is applied in our body movements. On the basic postures, we build exercise. Rhythm is added to all those postures and make it more lively, then we'll show you how it is performed. If each position is exploited in rhythm, which makes the onlooker something amazing, something beautiful. Just show with just one tattara.
Thank you.
practice exercise for body to get the speed.